Good day, everyone. I am Given Lapid from BSc English 2A. And for today's lesson, I will be discussing the continuation about the topic Literature After EDSA. This video lecture is divided into two parts. And for first part, the story Magnificence by Estrella Alfon. Before we go to the main topic, let's have a short glimpse about the author's background. Estrella Alfon was born in San Nicolas, Cebu City on March 27, 1917. Even if her parents were shoekeepers, she managed to attend college to study medicine. During her college, she was mistakenly diagnosed with tuberculosis. She was sent to a sanitarium to be quarantined and decided to resign from her pre-medical education. She died on December 28, 1983, due to a heart attack which she suffered on stage during the awards night of Manila Film Festival. Alfon set many of her stories in the fictional community of Espeleta, a recognizable lower-middle-class district of Cebu City. Though she wrote mostly in English, she also wrote some stories in Cebuano. Of the women writers of the region, she is among the most prominent. For our main event, Magnificence, a story by Estrella Alfon. The story started with a man named Vicente coming to the house of the two children to tutor them with their schoolworks. The family, especially the mother, trusted Vicente wholeheartedly, for they think that the man was always so gentle, so kind, and there was nothing to fear with when he is around. When Vicente came earlier than usual one evening, the children immediately put their lesson down, sharing stories to him about his classmates being envious with the pencils he gave them. The children wanted Vicente to buy them more pencils. Then, Oscar was asked by Vicente to get a glass of water. Vicente held the little girl up lightly in his arms and held her to sit down on his lap. The little girl felt uncomfortable and kept squirming. Vicente's face was wet with sweat and his eyes looked strange. The girl jumped away from Vicente. The mother saw what has happened. He slapped Vicente and threw him out of the house. To further understand the story, I included a video about Magnificence. This video was made by Jot Jot Feliciano and was uploaded in YouTube. So, here it goes! Thank you. I hope that through the video, you already understand the message of the story. Now, let's move on to the elements of the story. The setting. The story was set in the house where the little girl and little boy lived with their parents. Next is the characters in the story. The first one is the little girl. She is the protagonist in the story. She is also defined as a static character because she remained innocent throughout the story. Next one is Oscar. He is also defined as a static character because he remained oblivious to the motives of the man. Unlike Oscar and the little girl, the mother was defined as a dynamic character because she is kind to the man before she realized that the man has bad motives for her daughter. The father is also a static character because he was trusting the man until the end. Lastly, Vicente, the antagonist in the story. He is defined as a dynamic character because he was fond on the children but later on took advantage on the little girl. Let's move on to the plot of the story. The exposition. The story started with a man named Vicente coming to the house of the two children to tutor them with their schoolworks. The family absolutely trust him, for they think that this man was always so gentle, so kind, and there was nothing to fear with when he is around. The rising action. The rising action is when Vicente came earlier usual in that evening. The children immediately put their lesson down, telling him of the envy of their schoolmates and would buy them more pencils. Then, Vicente asked Oscar, the younger brother, to get him some glass of water. The climax is when Vicente held the little girl by the arm, then let the girl take her full trust, and when he took the little girl up lightly in his arms, and holding her under armpits, then held her to sit down on his lap. Then the girl kept squirming, and for somehow she felt uncomfortable to be held and looked around at Vicente, interrupting her careful writing to twist around. Then Vicente's face was wet with sweat and his eyes looked strange. The following action is when the girl jumped away from Vicente's lap. Then the mother came downstairs holding in her hand the merienda for them. She talked to Vicente and slapped him, then shows him out of the house. For our resolution, the little girl fell asleep, oblivious of what happened. Let's now jump to the themes of the story. The first one is trust. The story showed how trust can easily come out of innocence. The second one is mother's love. The magnificence of the mother showed on how she defended her child. The third one is women empowerment. The story shows how a mother will turn to a woman to fight for a mother's rights in terms of abuses. For point of view, the story is in third person omniscient because the author sees all, knows all, and tells all what is the story supposed to be. For symbolism, the first one is pencils. It was said that during those times, colorful pencils were a hit, And so giving the kids these pencils are a form of bribe so that Vicente could get along with the kids well, and they would not doubt him. The second one is the term woman to mother. Note that at the first few paragraphs of the story, the mother was addressed as the woman, and not until she defended her daughter against Vicente that she was addressed as the mother. To sum it all up, the moral lesson of the story is, trust is not inherited, but it is gained. And for our second part, the story, How My Brother Leon Brought Home a Wife, by Manuel E. Argilia. Before we go to the main topic, let's have a short glimpse about the author's background. Manuel E. Argilia was an Ilocano who wrote in English. He was best known for a short story, How My Brother Leon Brought Home a Wife, which received first prize in the Commonwealth Literary Contest in 1940. Most of his stories depict life in Barrio Nagrapkan, Baoang, La Union, where he was born in 1911. He earned his Bachelor of Arts in Education in 1933 at the University of the Philippines. He became a member and later the president of the UP Writers Club and editor of the Literary Apprentice. He married Lydia Villanueva, another talented writer, and they lived in Ermita, Manila. Let's now jump to our main topic, How My Brother Leon Brought Home a Wife, a story by Manuel Argilia. Baldo was able to meet his brother's wife, Maria. As Baldo saw his older brother's wife, he described her as lovely, tall, and beautiful. Upon their journey to Leon's home, Leon is wondering why Baldo drove them to the Waig instead of the Camino Real. Baldo answered that he drove the Waig because their father told him to do so. The Waig route will serve as a test to Maria if she can live in the province, which differs a lot from the city where she lived in. But then, it seems that Maria liked Leon's province. She described this as beautiful, fresh air, clean, and free of dust. During their journey, Maria was worried if Leon's father and family would like her. When they arrived home, father talked to Baldo, asking what happened during their travel. The father asked Baldo if Maria was afraid in their place. Baldo answered that Maria was not afraid and instead she enjoyed the journey. To further understand the story, I also prepared a video for you to watch. Here it goes!
The story started when Baldo met his older brother and his wife Maria at the edge of Nagrebkan, La Union. Caseline drove them with a kalesa from the terminal. As Baldo saw his manong's wife, he described her as lovely, tall, and beautiful. In her is reflected a woman who, though described as civilized, still shows the values atypical of a maiden in ancient times.
You are Baldo, and this must be Labang, whom I heard so much.
You may scratch his forehead now.
Maria hesitantly touched Labang's head and scratched it daintily. While Leon pays Caseline, Baldo is captured by the beauty of Maria. Baldo heard his brother Leon call Maria by her name. For Baldo, the name Maria will also be how they will call her, not Maring, not Mayang. But Baldo was quite confused when he heard Maria answer Leon by the name Noel. He thought that their father would not like it, but for him, the name Noel sounds better. Baldo also saw how the two are deeply in love. Meanwhile, Labang made a loud sound that made Maria amazed. Then Maria asked,
"Why does he make that sound?"
"There is no other like it. It's the only bull who does that sound.
If you continue to talk about him like that, either I shall fall in love with him or become greatly jealous."
Upon their journey to their home, Leon is wondering why Baldo drove them to the Waig instead of the Camino Real.
"It was Father Manong. He told me to drive at Waig instead of the plain Camino Real."
The Waig route served as test to Maria if she can live in the province, which differs a lot from the city where she lived in. But then it seems like Maria likes Leon's province. She described this as beautiful, fresh air, clean, and free of dust. Baldo even described the beauty that they saw while traversing the Waig. He mentioned how the Katayagan hills formed a silhouette when the sun set, how the crickets chirped, how the dangla and arais roots smelled.
"Look, there's our star, Noel."
"I have been looking at it. Do you remember how I would tell you that when you want to see stars, you must come to Nagrabkan?"
"Yes, Noel. Look at it. It's so many times bigger and brighter than it was at Ermita Beach."
It was already dark and Baldo lighted the lamp. They saw the Andadasi and Arrais along the Waig. And then, Leon suddenly sang a song with Maria.
"Like the fog is lifted, and at last I see the light.
And it's like the sky is blue,
and it's warm and real bright, and the world has somehow shifted."
"Have we far to go yet, Noel?"
"Soon we will get out of the Waig and pass into the fields. After the fields is our home, Manong."
"Then the Camino Real curves around the foot of the Katayagan Hills and passes by our house. And I'll ask Father why we drove through the Waig."
"Noel, do you think he will like me?"
"Does that worry you still, Maria? Father is the gentlest man I know." While continuing their journey, Maria was worried if Leon's father and family would like her. When they arrived home, Mother was smiling shyly on the doorway. Leon immediately asked her mother, "Where is Tatang Nanang?"
"He is at his room upstairs. His leg is bothering him again."
Father was in his room smoking his tobacco in the window. He talked to Baldo, asking what happened during their travel.
"Did you meet anybody on the way?"
"No, Father. Nobody passes through the Waig at night. She is very beautiful, Father."
"Was she afraid of Labang?"
"No, Father. She was not afraid. She looked at the stars, Father, and Manong Leon sang."
"What did he sing?"
"Sky sown with stars. She sang with him, Father."
Father was silent again. Baldo could hear the low voices of Mother and his sister Aurelia downstairs. While Baldo and Father were in the dark and smoky room, the door opened and Leon and Maria came in. So, Father suddenly changed the topic and told him to let Labang drink water.
I hope that through the video, you already understand the message of the story. Now, let's move on to the elements of the story. Setting. The story was set in Nagrabkan, La Union, Leon's hometown. This story takes place in a farm where people would usually ride in a carabao. Next is the characters in the story. The first one is Baldo, the one who narrated the story, and the younger brother of Leon. He is obedient, innocent, and naive boy. The second one is Leon or Noel, the older brother of Baldo who brought home a wife. He was a responsible, gentle, and a loving husband. The third one is Maria. She was born and grew up in a big city, and she is the wife of Leon. She was beautiful, supportive, creative, and a loving wife. The next one is the father, the one who instructed Baldo on what he will do while he is on the road with Leon and Maria, the mildest and gentlest man. The next one is Labang, the bull who brought the wife and Leon to the home. Baldo considered her as his pet, a hard-working pet. Let's move on to the plot of the story. The exposition. The inciting action was when Maria stepped down from the carretela of gasoline with a quick, delicate grace. She looked lovely and tall. She looked up to Leon with a smile, and her forehead was on level with his mouth. The rising action. They took the dry bed of Waig as a substitute of passing the Camino Real, and it was the wish of their father to go by Waig. Climax. The intense parts of the story are the challenges encountered by Maria. One of the good examples is when Maria tested if she will become irritated or not if she holds the bang. Also, when she rides on a cart because she wear a high heels and she chose to pass by Waig instead of Camino Real. Lastly, when Maria and Leon sang together the song Sky Sown of Stars, and when Leon asked her if she missed her city because Maria decided to live or start a new life with Leon in the province. The falling action came when Leon was searching for their father, and her mother told them that his leg is bothering him again. Resolution. The conclusion was when Baldo crossed the threshold of his father and asked him about Maria. Afterwards, the door opened and Leon and Maria came in. Baldo looked to Maria so lovely and went out to water the labang which his father told him. For the themes of the story, we have love. Love made Maria and Leon stronger whatever struggles come. The second one is sacrifice. One may have to give up some things in order to find happiness in life, or at least the best happiness that can be found in that particular life. The third one is determination. In order to achieve success, we must be strong enough, show determination, be patient on whatever difficult event or situation you must have to sacrifice just to be happy. The point of view of the story is first person. The narrator of the story is Baldo. For a symbolism, we have journey. It symbolizes the problems and obstacles that they have to face with their relationship, where a journey can have its ups and downs through the way. And for our moral lesson, we should respect and accept one's life. And that's it for our lesson today. I hope you learned something from me. The continuation of this visual lecture will be discussed by Ms. Ida Duran Victoria on our next synchronous meeting. Thank you for listening!